All right, here we go. We're going to start our broken mirror colored pencil portrait. We have our photo. In the good old days, we had to cut them out of magazines, and we would put this plastic sheet over it that had a grid printed on it, or we would just draw right on the magazine, measure out the grid. We don't really have to do that much anymore, but same idea. There's my grid on my portrait. There's my grid measured out. There's the portrait pre-sketch. We have done pre-sketches before. I'm not going to go over that other than to say to really want you to use that little half and half trick. Cut the boxes in half where you need to, see where it cuts halfway through here so you can be nice and accurate. So we can put this aside. Notice I've outlined it pretty dark so we can trace it easily. The main part of this video is to create that sense of a broken mirror. And here's how you do it. I'll bring this back a few times. First thing you want to do is get a piece of paper. This is computer paper. It depends on what I tell you in class, how big your drawing is going to be, but this fits well in the video frame. What we want to do is have a rule of composition called the rule of thirds. And what it is, and you don't have to do this, but I'm just going to show you what it is. If you don't know what it is, I cut this paper into equal thirds just by eyeballing it. And sometimes I will just literally put my fingers here and just see if it's pretty close. See, that's pretty close. And I can just make a mark right here and a mark right there and do that. The idea here is to, I think it looks more natural if in one of these four spots, that's where you put the center of the radiating mirror or glass shards coming out. That's a good way to organize it. Then you'll have some variety of bigger and smaller pieces. And something that's way far over or something that's right smack dab in the middle usually isn't quite as interesting. All right, so with that said, we don't have to do all of those lines, but you need to kind of visualize that. And I'll put it over here somewhere. So I'm picturing rule of thirds. And here's what you think about. Think about a ball crashing into a mirror right there and creating the glass or the mirror breaking to the outside, kind of the everything's radiating out. The idea here is to make it appear kind of like glass or a mirror, and it breaks in shards or sharp pieces. So right there is going to be where things come from, and everything's going to go out, just straight out from that point. So what I do, and I just do this freehand because I can draw fairly straight lines. What you do is just do a couple of gentle angles, let them continue to get wider. That helps. And then I usually start it with some kind of a broken little looking piece right there. Now, the next one we do can overlap. So I'm going to do another piece that starts here. It's as if this piece jumped up when it broke and landed on this one. So check this out, and there's going to be some open space. What you want to do usually is let these angles be kind of gentle, and I'll show you what not to do on another piece. And see, this is going to continue to come out a little bit. You can use a ruler if you want to, but I usually don't. I think glass might break a little bit with some curves, so that's totally fine. The other ones, they don't have to overlap like that. They can kind of be separate. I can let the beginning of this one have kind of an extra little angle. This one is going to come out. Now, you do not have to try to make it look like this one fits into this one like a little puzzle piece. That's no big deal. If you do, fine. See, these two don't really look like they fit perfectly together because other little pieces may have broke somewhere else. All right, let's do a few more. And the idea is to get the glass, the mirror pieces, to cover up, 75% of the space. And the, I don't like the angle of that one right there. I'm gonna bring it back this way more. And this is where you make those mistakes. And I'm gonna let this one, now see, the ones that come down here are going to just be longer. And they'll get bigger down here. So I'm gonna go like that, and I'm gonna put another piece of glass that just kind of broke off right there. That's totally fine. Now, what you don't want to do, I'll bring this one back. Don't make your glass pieces all crazy like that. That is not going to look as natural as if they kind of just gently broke, kind of little lightning bolts going out to the outside, these angles. Again, lightning bolts, you know, really have sometimes like that when you draw them. Don't do that. Lightning bolt is kind of a gentle lightning bolt. All right, so just a couple more here. And don't think about it too much other than not going crazy with all the angles. I would not make pieces that are really skinny. I don't think that'll work very well because we're gonna have to draw some facial features inside of those pieces. And let's see, let's make this next one go underneath both of those. And I'll let this one act like it goes way over here. And maybe one more. Let's say this one really broke off far away. Like that. That's enough. So now we can see where the negative space is. And I'll just barely color in a couple of those. And we can see where the glass shards kind of landed after it broke. All right, the next little video is going to talk about how to get the thickness of the glass shards, and that'll be a quick one. There you go.